Come, all the first PUC students, to this session. So this session we shall deal about scalars and vectors. In the previous session we defined what are scalars, what are vectors, how to represent scalars, how to represent vectors, and the different types of vectors. Okay, zero vector, unit vector, equal vector, scalar multiple of a vector, and all those things. Okay, so in this session we shall learn vector operation. Vector operation means how to add two vectors, addition of two vectors. Okay, P is one vector, Q is another vector. We want to add these two vectors, that is P plus Q, vector P plus vector Q. Okay, so vector addition is based on the following two laws, very important laws, that is law of triangle of vector addition and law of parallelogram of vector addition. Okay, first we shall take up law of triangle of vector addition. So if two vectors, these two vectors are represented both in magnitude and direction such that the final point of one coincides with the initial point of the other. You see, this is vector P. The direction is like this, magnitude is this much. We have represented the same magnitude and same direction, therefore this is same as P. Similarly, this is same as Q. It is both in magnitude and direction, but the only the difference, these two points I have shifted this vector, translated this vector to this point. Then if I represent them like this, the straight line joining the initial point of the first to the terminal point of the next, that gives their resultant. The resultant of two vectors P and Q is this vector. Okay, the sum of two vectors P plus Q gives R. R equals P plus Q. This gives their resultant. Resultant means a single vector which produces the same effect as that of a set of vectors. Okay, so the effect of these two vectors is same as this vector. That single vector is called resultant. Okay, this is how we can find the sum of these two vectors. Similarly, so in this law of parallelogram of vector addition, the same two vectors are represented both in magnitude and direction such that their initial points coincides. I will shift this vector to this point. Coincides, this is same as this, magnitude and direction is same, magnitude and direction is same. If I know these two adjacent sides, I can complete this parallelogram like this. This is the parallelogram. So the diagonal of the parallelogram gives their resultant. It is same as law of triangle of vector addition. R equals P plus Q. This is. Okay? So this vector is same as this. Therefore, this is also Q. This is same as this. This is also P. So according to law of triangle, if I add like this, Q plus P is this much, P plus Q is R. Therefore P plus Q equals Q plus P. So vector addition is commutative. Okay, right. So this is how we can add two vectors using the law of triangle and law of parallelogram. Okay, right. Now let us find the resultant of these two vectors. So vector P is represented by OA, vector Q is represented by OB. Let us, I will produce this, and then I will drop a perpendicular from this point. I will call this as D. This is, I will call this point as C. Okay, so I will call the angle between the two vectors as theta, then angle between the resultant and P as alpha. So if this angle is theta, this angle is also theta, because these two are parallel lines cut by a transversal. They are corresponding angles. Okay, so now we shall derive an expression to find the magnitude and direction of the resultant of two vectors. Okay, right. So from that figure, it is very clear that from right angled triangle ODC, this is the right angle triangle ODC, what I can write, OC square equals square on the hypotenuse equals sum of the squares on the other two sides, OD square plus DC square. Okay, now from right angle triangle ADC, what I can write? Yes, sin theta equals opposite side by hypotenuse is nothing but Q. Therefore I can write DC equals Q sin theta, cos theta equals adjacent side by hypotenuse. I can write AD equals Q cos theta. Then I can write one more relation. If I apply the Pythagoras theorem, what I can write? That AC square equals AD square plus BC square. This is a right angle triangle. From this is the hypotenuse. Square on the hypotenuse equals sum of the squares on the other two sides. Now if I expand this expression, OC square equals, I will write OD as OA plus AD. OA plus AD whole square plus DC square. Then A plus B whole square, I can write OC square equals OA square plus AD square plus 2OA into AD plus DC square. AD square plus DC square, I can write it as AC square. OC square equals OA square plus AC square plus 2 into OA into AD. Now look at the figure. I can write OC as R. Therefore R square equals OA as P. This AC is nothing but OB, is nothing but Q square plus 2 into OA. OA is nothing but P. AD is nothing but Q cos theta. Substitute this here. Okay. So finally, square of the resultant equals P square. R square equals P square plus Q square plus 2PQ into cos theta. This gives an expression for the magnitude of the resultant of two vectors P and Q. Okay, knowing the magnitude of two vectors and the angle between them, we can find out the magnitude of the resultant. Okay, make it very clear. So this vectors concept is very, very important. Please learn this derivation very clearly. So this derivation is usually asked in the examination frequently. To find the magnitude, derive an expression for the magnitude of the resultant of two vectors P, Q, R, A, B acting at a point. Okay, so this is how you can derive this expression. This gives magnitude. Then this alpha gives the direction. Okay, this resultant vector, how it is oriented, that is the direction. If alpha is 0 degree, R is along P itself. Okay, so knowing alpha, we can say what is the direction of the result. So therefore, let us derive an expression for alpha that gives the direction of the resultant. So from the right angle triangle ODC, tan alpha equals, you see, from this triangle ODC, tan alpha equals opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side is DC, adjacent side is OD. This is nothing but, okay, DC divided by OD. I can write it as OA plus AD. Therefore, tan alpha equals, if I substitute for DC, it is nothing but Q sin theta divided by OA is nothing but P, AD is nothing but Q cos theta. This gives an expression for the direction of the resultant. Okay, so this gives magnitude, this gives how much it is, this gives the orientation, that is direction of the resultant. This is how we can derive this expression. Now, after deriving these two expressions, let us move to special cases. So what are the special cases? Okay, so when these two vectors P and Q are in same direction, that is the special. When they are perpendicular to each other, when they are in opposite direction. So when the magnitude of two vectors are equal and opposite, what may be the result? This is what so we should think about in special cases. So in the first case, when PQ are in same direction, so what is the angle theta? Theta equals 0 degree. When they are in same direction, theta is 0 degree. When theta is 0 degree, what can you think about? Thus cos 0 degree is 1. Cos 0 is 1, this becomes P square plus Q square plus 2PQ. That is nothing but, so P plus Q whole square. Okay, R square equals cos 0 degree is 1. R square equals P plus Q whole square. R equals P plus Q. Let's see, the magnitude gets added up. So theta is also, when theta is 0, alpha is also 0. So then the vector acts in the same direction. Resultant also acts in the same direction. When they are in opposite direction, theta equals 180 degree. This vector is like this. This vector is like this. They are in opposite direction. Eta is 180 degree. Cos 180 degree is minus 1. Therefore, R square equals P minus Q. This becomes minus 1. So, P square plus Q square minus 2PQ. Therefore, it becomes P minus Q whole square. Therefore, R equals P minus Q. Difference in magnitude when they are in opposite direction. So, this special cases plays a very important role in the future course of study. Two forces are acting in opposite direction. What is the magnitude and direction of their resultant? Okay? So, you should subtract larger minus smaller. The resultant will be along larger. Okay? Third case, when they are in perpendicular direction. Okay? P is like this. Q is like this. What is the resultant? Then this is R from this right angle triangle. You can write R square equals P square plus Q square. Theta is 90 degree. Cos 90 degree equals 0 degree. Therefore, if this is 0, this term goes R square equals P square plus Q square. This gives the resultant. Okay? So, this is how we can find the magnitude and direction of the resultant of two vectors. Now, we shall move to vector subtraction. Look at the board clearly. Observe. Suppose this is vector P. Okay? Okay. This is vector Q. Then according to law of triangle of vector addition, yes. Okay. This is P plus Q. Now, I will represent, if this is Q, minus Q will be like this. Minus Q means magnitude is same, direction is opposite. This is minus Q. Now, if I add these two things, I will get this as the resultant. This is P plus of minus Q. This is nothing but P minus Q. Okay? This is vector addition. So, this is vector subtraction. Okay? So, this is how we can find the sum of two vectors, difference of two vectors. So, we shall discuss the special cases. So, when the sum is maximum, when they are in the same direction. Okay? When the difference is maximum, when they are in opposite, the difference is minimum when they are in opposite direction. Okay? So, these special cases can also be discussed. So, in future, we are going to use this vector addition and vector subtraction. So, during the course of our study. Okay? So, in the next session, we shall see vector multiplication. Please go through all these things clearly. Thank you.